today I'll be explaining some of the problems which are a little difficult to understand, and the rest ones you can do yourself. As for the first one, find the circumference of the circle of the given radius and diameter. This can be done by you. Find the area of the circle. This is also easy. You can do it. Find the radius of the circle whose circumference is this much. Means the circumference is given. You put it in the formula and you will get the radius. You have to find out the radius. I have explained these types of sums in during the example explanation. You can do it. Find the ratio of the circumferences of two circles whose radius are in ratio 4:5. So I am explaining this sum. Circumference of the circle we know is 2 pi r. For circle 1, radius is r. Why? Because they have given you that the radius r in a ratio of 4:5. So for circle 1, let's consider radius is r, and for circle 2, let's consider radius is equal to 5. Now, circle 1 is in ratio to circle 2. 2 pi r is equal to 2 pi r, since the circumferences are there. Now 2 pi instead of r will be writing 5, and here instead of r will be writing 5. Sorry, this here it will be 4 and here it will be 5. So when we cancel this 2 pi and this 2 pi, it can be cancelled, since this is ratio is 2 is replaced by equal to. So you are getting the answer 4:5. That this shows that if the radius is in a particular ratio, the circumference will also be in that same ratio. Now let's come to question number 5. The question number 5 is the inner circumference of a circular track. Let me show you the question first. The inner circumference of a circular track is 176 centimeter, and the track is 5 meter wide. Calculate the area of the track and the cost of putting a fence along the outer circle at the rate of 12 rupees per meter. For this, they have told you, I'm just explaining the sum, the solve, you have to solve it out. The inner circumference of a circular track is 176. So if I draw a diagram, this is the inner circular circle, and the circumference of it is 176 meter. Mind it, this is the circumference. This is the circumference of this inner circle, and the pathway around it is 7 meter wide. Okay. Now you have to calculate the area of this track. This type of sum I had explained you during the example explanation. I'll explain once again. From this circumference which is given, you have to find out the value of r. Now when we know this r is this much, so when we get this r, we will get, and plus this 7, that means the r will be this much for the outer circle. The r will be r plus, for the outer circle, the r will be r plus 7. Whatever r you get from the, means the radius from the inner circle, it will be r plus 7 for the outer circle. Clear? Now when you get this, they have told you to find out. So second thing which you have to do is, you have to find out the area of the inner circle and the area of the outer circle. Then when you subtract that, both of them, you will get the area of this pathway. This was the first part. The second part, they are asking you to put a fencing around the outer circle at the rate of 12 meter. Means again, you have to find out the fencing. You have to, if you have to fence this circle, you have to find out the circumference. So you find a circumference of this outer circle, and then you have to multiply by 12 meter, because it's per meter rupees 12, the fencing cost. You'll find out the answer. Okay. Now let's come to question number 6. The circumference of a circle exceeds by 37 centimeter. Find the diameter of the circle. Okay. Now what they are telling, there is a circle, okay, there is a circle who has a circumference, whatever it is, and it has a radius r. Now the circumference of the circle is 37 plus r means the circumference of the circle, of this particular circle, is equal to 37 plus r, because they are telling it exceeds its radius by 37. Okay, so it will be 37 plus r. Now we know the formula for circumference is 2 pi r, and this is also 37 plus r. So what I'll suggest you here is you use 3.14, means instead of 22 by 7 you use 3.14, the value of pi. You can use 22 by 7, but I think that will be little more, means longer process for solving the thing. Clear? Yeah. So now 2 into 3.14 you get, say, leave this as it is, 6.28 r. Now we put the, we bring this r to this side. Now here r means what? 1 r. It cannot have 0 r, no, it's 1 r. R means 1 r. So when you subtract 6.28 r minus 1 r, you get 5.28 r, is equal to 37. Now here we have to find out the radius. They have told you to find out the radius. So radius is, actually they have told you to find out the diameter. So until and unless you find out the radius, you cannot find out the diameter. So here you come, 37 by 5.28, or this is the thing, you solve and get this. But when you are doing it in the copy, I want the calculation for this. If you don't calculate, you just write this thing, I'll give you zero in exam time. Mm-hmm. Just remember that, because I don't want you to use calculator and do the sum and give it to me. I'll completely give zero. Even if it's right, I won't give you marks. So it's 7. When you calculate, you will see it, you will be getting 7.007. Now we generally take two places after decimal, so we take it as 7, and we know diameter is equal to 2 r, so 2 into 7 is equal to 14. Okay, so this is the way how you have to do it. So understand the sum and then do it. Then let's come to question number 8. The circumferences of two circles are in ratio 1:2. Find their areas. There they had given you the radius, circumference and radius ratio, and they have told you to find out the circumference in question number 4. In question number 8, they are asking you, they have given you the circumference that are in a ratio of 1:3, and they have told you to find out the ratio of their areas. Clear? So let's take it this way. Circumference of circles are 1:3 as it is given. Now let's see C1 and C2. C1 means circle 1 and circle 2. And here I am writing C means it is 2 pi r. The circumference is 2 pi r. So for the first one, let the circumference be x. Or then, or we can write C1 is equal to x. Means the circle 1 is 2x and the circle 2 is 3x. As they have given in the ratio. So now x will be equal to 2 pi r. The C is x, so 2 pi r. So we have to find out the area. For finding out areas, we know the formula for area is 2 pi r, pi r square. So we have to know the value of r. So here, from here we find out r. How? We keep the r this side, we take 2 pi below, and we find x by 2 pi. Similarly here, for C2, when it is 3x, 3x is equal to 2 pi r, or r is equal to 3x by 2 pi. This is for C2. Now let's come to the area. Area, as I told, it is pi r square. So when C is equal to x, then, and r is equal to x by 2 pi. That is for the first case. The area 1 will be pi into r square, means 2x by 2 pi, x by 2 pi. We cancel this pi and this pi. X into x is x square, it is not 2x. X plus x is 2x, whereas x into x is x square. And 2 into 2 pi will be 4 pi. We got one. Now for the second one, when the circumference is 3x and the radius is 3x by pi, pi r square will be pi into 3x by 2 pi. Cancel this pi and this pi. 3 into 3, 9, and x into x square, so it will be 9x square by 4 pi. Now the ratio of area will be x square by 4 pi, and the next one will be 9x square by 4 pi. So we cancel x square, 4 pi, 4 pi, we get the answer 1 is to 9 answer. Now number 9, the question number 9. A copper wire in form of a circle encloses an area of 616 centimeter. If the same wire is bent into square, find the area. Use pi this. Now, this is there is a copper wire that is in a form of a circle whose area is this much. Now, this same wire of the same dimension is made into a square. Okay? And you have to find out the area of this square. This example also, this same sum I have explained you. So, you can do. So, your homework for today is till number 9.